Hello, good morning and happy Sunday, boys and girls. I'm so happy that you joined us at Kids Connection today. I am Mrs. Michelle from Sacramento First Church of the Nazarene, and I've got a great story for you today. We are talking about, have you guys ever been jealous of your brothers or sisters before? Sibling rivalry? Well, this is a story that's definitely based in sibling rivalry, but even stronger in God's will and power. So it's a two-part story. The first part we're gonna talk about, we're gonna learn about Jacob, and he has 12 sons. And the youngest of all is his favorite. And oh my goodness, how jealous are the other 11 brothers. So it's a wonderful story. And I'm in a different room of my house again to do this recording for you today. And it's because this time of day, I get this beautiful rainbow behind me. There's one over here too, let's see. I get this rainbow on the walls that have come from my windows when the sun is just rising at the right time. So I thought that would be fun to show you that because this is a very colorful story. And I've got a fun craft in store for us today. And as usual, at the end of this video, you'll see a wonderful cartoon of the entire story. So pay attention. I hope you enjoy this story and the craft. And let's go ahead and do our opening prayer before we go ahead with the rest of the lesson. You ready? Heavenly Father, thank you for this time we have together, Lord Jesus. Thank you for clearing the air. The smoke was so bad. It was bothering my asthma. I'm doing much better today. I know that it's healthier for all of us, and now we can get outside and play. I pray that you continue to remind us to lead a Christian life. We're not just Christian on Sundays, we're Christian every day. And so we pray that you open our minds, our hearts, our souls, so that we can hear the word, understand the word, but most importantly, live your word. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. Get ready for a great story and a wonderful craft, and I will see you next Sunday. Bye-bye. Hello, Kids Connection, and thank you for joining us for the craft portion of our video. So, this might give you a big hint, and I said it would be a very colorful story today. So remember, we're talking about Jacob and his 12 sons, and the youngest, the 12th one, is really special to Jacob. So Joseph gets a special, special coat. Do you remember the coat of many colors? We have talked about this story before. And so I've got two different ideas today, and I'll show you this first one, and you can kind of see over here, there's a hint of the other one. I'll show you, it's really easy to draw a coat, because back in those days when Jesus was around, their coats were sort of just robes that went over their tunic. So I just did a scoop for the neck, just do a line that's straight down a little bit for the shoulders, and then you just do a longer line for the longer line for the sleeve. They kind of had large sleeves back then. And you go like this to close off the sleeve. And then you just finish out the robe. One side, and then you can pull across for the bottom. And then I made a little V here so that we can show where the robe opens. So that is easy breezy lemon squeezy. And you can do this with any little scrap. You can see this is my recycled paper. It's got hole punches in it and markings over here. So I'm just recycling this paper. And then we can do stripes. It's a really colorful robe. So we can put any color stripes we want in here. You might want to do it kind of like a rainbow. It's completely up to you. You can make this as colorful as you want because in the story, we know it is a very colorful robe that Jacob had made for Joseph. And gosh, what do you think? Do you think those 11 other brothers are really excited that they didn't get anything and that their dad kind of did something to spoil Joseph? I don't think so either. So this craft is really simple. You can do it on paper, but I thought it might be a little more fun. You guys know, what do I love to recycle? That's right, toilet paper tubes. I thought this would be really clever because it stands up on its own because it's a toilet paper tube. And all I did was take some scissors and just regular old, oops, where are they? Regular old scissors. And you can picture, here's the top of what it used to look like, right? So all I did was scoop for the neck, just like our drawing. I just did a scoop for the neck, and then I went down for the sleeve, and I went down for the shoulders like this, and then down for the sleeve, and then I just trimmed it in to make a little bit of a sleeve for him there, and I cut an opening there so he can get his head in. And then I just used the very same markers, and I colored some stripes on there. What I really like about this one, as I said, is look, it stands up because it's got that opening on the bottom. Oh, and you know what? I didn't color the back. I should color the back. I'll have to go back and do that. So isn't that adorable? I love that. And this, I thought, oh, with this opening, with these little sleeves like this, you can put some twine or some string on there and we can hang it on the Christmas tree. Yes, it is getting close enough to start thinking about that. And this is very colorful, and it's a wonderful lesson because even though his brothers were jealous and they did something that was not nice at all, and you would think something horrible was going to happen, God was there for him. God was looking out for him. So we are never alone, and it doesn't matter who is against us because God is with us. And I think that is one of the best things that I could ever have in my corner, is knowing that God is with me always. So I hope you enjoy this story. I hope you enjoyed our little easy breezy lemon squeezy craft. Of course, you can cut this guy out if you'd like. You can punch a hole in him and hang him up, or you can do, I'm loving the toilet paper tube guy right here, this little colorful robe. I'll go ahead and color the rest of him later, because as I said, you can put little string or ribbon under his sleeves here and hang him on the Christmas tree. You can also just punch a hole here and hang him on the Christmas tree. So I hope that we can start making some ornaments to get ready for that beautiful, blessed season of Christmas. And I hope you have a very blessed Sunday, and I will see you next week. Bye-bye.
The Dreamer. Jacob had 12 sons, but he loved his son Joseph the most. He gave Joseph a special brightly colored coat. Joseph's brothers were jealous of him. They hated him. Joseph also had special dreams. In my dream, we were tying up bundles of wheat, he said, and your bundles bowed down to mine. Joseph's brothers hated him even more. Joseph had another dream. The sun, the moon, and 11 stars bowed down before me. His father and brothers grumbled. Are you saying you will rule over us? One day, Joseph's brothers were in the fields watching their sheep. They saw him coming to see them. They planned to kill him and put an end to all his dreams. It would be wrong to kill our brother, said Reuben. Let's throw him in this empty well. So they tore off Joseph's special coat and threw him into the well. Ishmaelite traders came by on their way to Egypt. Let's sell Joseph as a slave to the Ishmaelites, suggested Judah. So the brothers sold Joseph for 20 pieces of silver. The brothers dipped Joseph's coat in goat's blood and showed it to Jacob. My son is dead, he wept. Meanwhile, Joseph was taken to Egypt. But God was with Joseph. In Egypt, the Ishmaelites sold Joseph to Potiphar, one of Pharaoh's captains. God blessed Joseph and made him successful. Potiphar put Joseph in charge of his whole household.